He said it, I didn't. Guy, Polly, would you get off the phone and, you know, pay attention to what's going on in the room?
I'll take care.
Okay.
If you don't mind, can you address it as also the Hot Stuff International? Eddie Spector wants you to monitor. He doesn't like it when you insult him that way.
I can't believe you're taking phone calls up here in the Eagles Nest, but you cut it out and pay attention to the match. I could care less what Eddie Gilbert,
from
you know,
the greatest
has
city
to say about what I'm calling in the booth here.
Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighed 235 pounds. This is the fabulous James Douglas.
Ugly state of Texas, whatever team with Tito Santana. And I'm not saying,
well, because Tito's a wetback, or, well, because he's from Mexico, I guess that means he's a pickpocket, or that he's an illegal alien.
I'm just saying, I never thought I'd ever see the day that a Texan would trust a Mexican. And you know why?
Why is that, Paul?
Because, as they always taught me in grammar school, if there had been a back door at the Alamo, Texas would be in Mexico.
Holy, amazingly, that you did get all those to crack in on Tito Santana, though, wasn't it? Stan Hansen was starting with driving that big elbow into the forehead of Shane Douglas. Whip Shane across the ring. Oh, an elbow by Stan Hansen. Then Shane Douglas to the wrong corner trying to tag in Tito Santana. That's not going to work.
Now tell me, you know, I know Hansen and Santana have scored to settle with Morocco, but what's the grudge against Shane Douglas?
He was a member of the Dangerous Alliance.
So does that make him a bad person automatically? I mean, don't you let a guy commit his evil deeds first? Look at Hansen chasing Shane around the ring. I mean, you know, and look at Santana now. Santana's mauling the magnificent Morocco.
Stan Hansen now back up on the ring apron. I don't think Don Morocco and Shane Douglas were quite ready for this matchup tonight. I don't think that Stan Hansen, Tito Santana, a team that we haven't seen here before in the ECW, and so far so good.
Yeah, so far so good. A Texan and a Mexican. I mean, that's an odd couple if I ever saw one.
Kind of like Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and the Dark Patriot, Paul?
No, not kind of like that at all. I don't understand that comparison whatsoever.
Oh, okay. I think the fans of the ECW understand what I'm trying to get at.
There are absolutely no problems within the Dangerous Alliance and Hot Stuff International, and that includes whatever rumors you rumor mongers want to stir up between Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and the Dark Patriot. Now, whoa!
Don Morocco steps over Tito Santana, but right to the face of Stan Hansen, and Don backs out of the way, right to that big right hand of Tito Santana, followed up by one from Stan Hansen, and a third by Tito Santana. Don Morocco's in trouble in the wrong corner, Paul Lee, dangerously. He was match right at the moment, but Tito Santana fight back, trying to make that tag to Stan Hansen. There's the tag! Stan Hansen in the ring! Oh, come on! Don Morocco had the referee distracted, unable to made the tag, and now Morocco and Shane Douglas firing away with those closed fists on Tito Santana.
I told you, a Texan and someone from Mexico. I'm not even calling him a Mexican, so nobody thinks I'm insulting him because of his heritage. But a person born in the state of Texas and a person born in the country of Mexico can never be a cohesive unit. And now Morocco, working on the trapezius muscles of Tito Santana. Notice, he's digging those fingers way into the muscle. He's trying to rip that muscle away from the bone. This is an extremely painful nerve hold.
We've talked about this before, Paulie, but I noticed again, Don Morocco's got that hand and that thumb especially all taped up, and I'm just wondering what effect that tape might have on this nerve hold he's got applied to Tito Santana.
Oh, it doesn't have any effect at all. I mean, Don has a hangnail, and
this is the same old hangnail, Corey. You've got to come up with something better than that, Paulie. You don't tape your whole hand and your thumb because you've got a hangnail. Tito Santana firing back now.
Notice Morocco blocks up the tag. This draws in Stan Hansen. This allows Morocco and Douglas an opportunity for a double team, but the referee, great presence of mind, turns around 1-2, and another lucky kick out by Tito Santana.
I don't know if I'd call it a lucky kick out, but I would have to agree with your last statement, Paulie. Don Morocco and Shane Douglas, wow, they're working very well together. What a team you've got here, Paulie.
And now you notice Shane, the fabulous one, Douglas, leaning into Tito Santana, grinding that shin lock. He's leaning right into Santana. You know, some people like to lean back, some people like to lean forward. It's different points of leverage. And look at this now. Now, is this called for?
Hey, I'm not going to tell Stan Hansen what he can and what he can't do. I don't think the referee is either right now. Stan Hansen in the ring to break things up. Don Morocco, though, back in control.
Yeah, notice that Morocco is dragging Santana away from his own corner. Hansen trying to reach out, trying to make that tag, but to no avail. And now Santana in grave danger of being at the mercy of the hands of Shane the Fabulous One Douglas and the Magnificent Morocco, because they will show no mercy at all. And look at that. So close, yet so far away again. Hansen can't tag in.
You know, Santana needs the tag in the worst kind of way. Stan Hansen just... a caged animal over there in the corner needs to get into this match. Don Morocco, Shane Douglas doing an excellent job of cutting off the ring here. And Tito Santana is in all kinds of trouble.
Yeah, Tito Santana is in all kinds of trouble. And now Shane Douglas setting him up for a fabulous suplex. Whoa, good block by Santana.
And Tito gets Shane up for a beautiful vertical suplex of his own. Now Tito's got to get over to that corner. Stan Hansen reaching out in vain, trying to make that tag. Tito's trying to work his way over that corner. He's deep better. Oh! Douglas and Stan Hansen and Don Morocco, what a collision these two have in the center of the ring. The ring is broken. Unbelievable, man. Don Morocco and Stan Hansen have broken the top ring rope. Here comes the Dark Patriot. Here comes Jimmy Superfly Snuka-Pauly. What's going on here? Eddie Gilbert's in the ring right now.
It's about time that Stan Hansen learned that when you play with fire, you're going to get burnt.
You saw it! Eddie Gilbert throwing fire at Stan Hansen, missing right in the eyes of the Dark Patriot. That's got to be it, man. The final straw. That's got to be the end of Eddie Gilbert and the Dark Patriot. There's no way these two are going to be able to continue to team together in the future. Unbelievable. Hot stuff, Eddie Gilbert.